Hello everyone. So in the previous class, we have learned the derivation of simple harmonic motion starting from the Hooke's law, and we have derived its solution. That is y is equal to e sin omega t plus phi. Now there is not one such solution for simple harmonic motion. We have other solution as well, and that I am going to explain now. So previously we have derived the solution of differential equation of SHM, and the differential equation we wrote it as d2y by dt square plus omega square y is equal to 0. So we have arrived at the solution for this differential equation. Y is equal to a sin omega t plus phi, where a is the amplitude, omega is angular frequency, and phi is the initial phase of the wave function. So and omega t plus phi is the total phase. So when phi initially, when y is equal to 0, phi will be equal to 0. Now let us write the other solutions, which y will be equal to a cos omega t plus phi as well. So this is in terms of sine and cos. We can find out the solution in terms of both sin and cos. So y can be written as c sin omega t plus d cos omega t. So if this is the solution of the simple harmonic motion, then in this case the amplitude of the wave is given by square root of c square plus d square, and the phase of the wave function, it will be equal to tan inverse of d by c. We can assign it as equation number 3 and this as equation number 3a and 3b. We can arrive to the solution y is equal to c cos omega t plus d sin omega t, and in this case again the amplitude of the wave, it will be equal to c square plus d square, but the phase of the wave function, it will be equal to tan inverse of minus d by a. So I have just written the final equations. You can take for arriving at equation y is equal to c sin omega t plus d cos omega t, you can expand a sin omega t plus phi in terms of sin a plus b is equal to sin a into cos b plus cos a into sin b, and then simplify to get the equation y is equal to c sin omega t plus d cos omega t. And you can take equation 2 by taking the expansion of trigonometric formula c cos a plus b is equal to cos a into cos b minus sin a into sin b. So in this case your amplitude in the both the case, either you write y is equal to c sin omega t plus d cos omega t, or y is equal to c cos omega t plus d sin omega t. In both the case the amplitude of the wave, simple harmonic motion, it is square root of c square plus d square, but the phase are opposite to the, here it is plus d by c and here, sorry, it is minus d by c. Now we can even write the solution of the simple harmonic motion in exponential form. So in the exponential form we can write y is equal to a exponential of minus I omega t plus phi, or the another solution we can write it as y is equal to c into exponential of plus I omega t plus d into exponential of minus I omega t. So these all are y is equal to a sin omega t plus phi, y is equal to a cos omega t plus phi, y is equal to c sin omega t plus d cos omega t, y is equal to c cos omega t plus d sin omega t in the sin and cos form, and in the exponential form it can be written as y is equal to a exponential of minus I omega t plus phi and y is equal to c into exponential of plus I omega t plus d into exponential of minus I omega t. So now we will learn how to derive, already we have learned about the displacement equation. We will find out velocity and acceleration of the simple harmonic motion, and then we will try to represent the simple harmonic motion, means displacement, velocity and acceleration, in terms of phasor diagram. So we will now go for expression for displacement, velocity and acceleration and phasor representation of simple harmonic motion. We have derived the displacement equation for SHM, which is y is equal to a sin omega t plus phi. Now what we know, that velocity is rate of change of displacement with respect to time. So let us differentiate the equation 1. So differentiating y with respect to t, we get dy by dt, which is, you can say it is velocity of the SHM. And differentiating a is constant, differentiating sin omega t plus phi, we get omega, which is a multiple of t, it will be so differentiating a sin omega t plus phi will get dy by dt is equal to a omega cos omega t plus phi. We can also write this equation as a omega sin omega t plus phi plus pi by 2 as sine pi by 2 means 90 plus theta is equal to cos theta. So what we can, if we compare equation 1 and 3, what we can say that velocity leads the displacement by pi by 2. Comparing equation 3 and 1, we can say that velocity leads the displacement, that is y, by pi by 2. Or we can say displacement lags the velocity by pi by 2. Next, again what we have to solve for to draw the phasor diagram, we must know that at the origin and at the extreme, what will be the velocity of the body executing SHM? So for this, first if we write, solve equation 1, what we get? Sine omega t plus phi is equal to y by a. Sine omega t plus phi, here sine omega t plus phi is equal to y by a. Now we have to find the velocity maximum. What could be the maximum velocity? So what we know that sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. So cos square theta will be equal to 1 minus sine square theta. So taking that in consideration, what we can write, cos omega t plus phi is equal to square root of 1 minus sine square omega t plus phi. Cos omega t plus phi is equal to 1 minus sine square omega t plus phi. Again repeating, we took the concept sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. So cos square theta will be equal to 1 minus sine square theta, and hence cos theta will be equal to square root of 1 minus sine square theta. Now further what we can write, cos omega t plus phi is equal to square root of 1 minus sine omega t plus phi value is y by a. Let us substitute it here. So y by a whole square, you get it 1 a square minus y square divided by a square, and this can be written as 1 by a square root of a square minus y square. So cos omega t plus phi, we get it 1 by a square root of a square minus y square. What we know that the velocity is equal to a omega cos omega t plus phi. So using equation 2 and 4, we can write the velocity, that is dy by dt, is equal to A omega, and in place of cos omega t plus phi, we can replace it by 1 by A square root of A square minus y square. So it will be square root of A square minus y square divided by A, and this will be equal to omega square root of A square minus y square. So further, what we get? V is equal to omega into square root of A square minus y square. Let us write it as equation number 5. So what we did here, we have derived the expression for cos omega t plus phi and then substituted in equation 2 to get the velocity expression in terms of amplitude and the displacement. So what we get, V is equal to omega square root of A square minus y square, where here A and A you have, it will be cancelled out. So now we have to find out what will be the velocity maximum. And while explaining the basics of oscillation, I have explained that at the origin the velocity it will be maximum, and at the extreme velocity will be equal to zero. So if we take the condition y is equal to 0, the velocity will be maximum. So V max will be equal to omega square root of A square, as y square is equal to 0, or V max is equal to omega into A. Remember this equation, we'll take it further to solve some problem as well. So we have arrived now for the velocity maximum, that is equal to omega into A. Now if we compare this equation 6 and 2, what we can say, if cos omega t plus phi is equal to 1, then the velocity will be maximum, means V will be equal to A into omega or omega into A, as we have derived from the vigorous solution that V max is equal to omega into A. So compare it, when cos omega t plus phi is equal to 1, and it is in the case when the theta value will be equal to 0. So we get V is equal to omega into A or A into omega. So next let us find out what will be the acceleration of the body which is executing simple harmonic motion, and what is the acceleration maximum. So we know y is equal to A sin omega t plus phi. Let us go for the acceleration. And acceleration, we define it as rate of change of velocity with respect to time, and we have arrived the equation for velocity, that is A omega cos omega t plus phi, and velocity is A omega cos omega t plus phi. So therefore acceleration, which is rate of change of velocity with respect to time can be represented by double differential in terms of displacement. So what it will be, A, if you differentiate the phase, you'll get omega. So omega into omega, it is omega square, and cos omega t plus phi differentiation is minus will write in front, minus sin omega t plus phi. So this equation we can again write it as A omega square sin of omega t plus phi plus phi as sin of pi plus theta is equal to minus sin theta. So if we compare equation 1 and 7, we can say that acceleration equation leads the displacement by pi, or we can, another words we can say that acceleration and the displacement are antiphase. So in the earlier equation, what we suggested that if cos omega t plus phi is equal to 1, the velocity will be maximum. Similarly, we can say that if sin omega t plus phi is equal to 1 in equation 7, then the acceleration maximum can be written as minus A omega square. So what we can say here from this diagram, that if velocity is maximum, now what we define the velocity as rate of change of displacement with respect to time, and acceleration as rate of change of velocity with respect to time. So here velocity is maximum and we can say that it is no more changing. So acceleration at the origin, it will be equal to 0. And at the extreme end, what is the acceleration? It is minus A omega square. And when we go to the either side, it will be plus A omega square. Acceleration will be plus A omega square. So briefly, when displacement is equal to 0, at that time velocity is maximum and acceleration is 0, and at the extreme when the amplitude is maximum, then velocity is equal to 0 and in the either positive direction of the displacement, as we understand that displacement and acceleration are oppositely directed in the case of simple harmonic motion, your acceleration at the maximum amplitude condition, that is y is equal to a will be minus a omega square, and in the negative displacement the acceleration will be positive, that is a omega square. So let us draw the phasor diagram for the simple harmonic motion taking displacement, acceleration and velocity in consideration. Okay, so we have derived the displacement equation, y is equal to a sin omega t plus phi, differentiated this to get the velocity expression, which is a omega cos omega t plus phi. And if we express the velocity in terms of sine, what we get? velocity is equal to a omega sin omega t plus phi plus pi by 2. As I have already explained how we have arrived to these equations. And if you differentiate the displacement equation twice or the velocity equation once, what you will get? Acceleration is equal to minus a omega square sin omega t plus phi. And if we remove the negative sign, we get a omega square sin omega t plus phi plus pi. So, if we compare this equation, displacement equation and the velocity equation, what we can say that velocity leads the displacement by pi by 2, or the displacement lags the velocity by pi by 2. And if we compare the displacement at the acceleration equation, then what we see that acceleration leads the displacement by pi, or the displacement lags the acceleration by pi. And if we compare the velocity and the acceleration equation, we see that acceleration leads the velocity by pi by 2. Pi minus pi by 2 is pi by 2. So based on this and the expression what we have derived for the velocity and the acceleration maximum, we saw that when y is equal to 0 at the origin, at the mean position, or at the position of equilibrium, what we say, your velocity is maximum, and that is given by a omega, and in that or in the mean position the acceleration is 0. Similar, what I have explained, y is equal to at the extreme means the maximum amplitude, y is equal to plus a, then velocity at the extreme it will be equal to 0 and acceleration will be minus a omega square. Similarly, if the displacement is in the either direction of the axis, means negative x axis or the negative y axis, then y is equal to minus a, and at that maximum amplitude at the extreme velocity will be 0 and acceleration will be maximum, that is plus a omega square. That is all we have discussed previously. Now let us try to represent it by the phase diagram. So in the phase diagram we have represented phasor diagram. In the phasor diagram we have represented displacement, velocity and acceleration. The amplitude we have origin, and the maximum amplitude is minus a or plus a. In the positive y direction it is plus a, and negative y direction it is minus a. Similarly, velocity in positive direction it is a omega, negative it is minus a omega, and acceleration is plus a omega square and minus a omega square. Now taking the how much velocity leads the displacement and how much acceleration leads the displacement, we can draw the phase diagram. At the origin, when y is equal to 0, the velocity is maximum, that is plus a omega. At the origin, y is equal to 0, velocity is maximum, that is a omega, and the acceleration is 0. Next, coming to the positive extreme end, what we know, y is equal to plus a. If I draw it like this, y is equal to 0, y is equal to plus a, and y is equal to minus a. Horizontal representation I am doing, but we are drawing it where the displacement y, what we know, y is vertical. So here when the displacement is maximum at the extreme, the velocity will be equal to 0 and the acceleration will be maximum. And we know the displacement and acceleration are antiphase, so it is minus a omega square. Coming to the next, so coming when again y is equal to 0, your velocity is maximum, But it can be either it is negative, that is minus a omega, and acceleration is 0. Again coming to the other position, that is minus a, when the amplitude is negative, negative y direction, then the velocity at the extreme it will be equal to 0, and the acceleration it will be maximum, and so on. If you go to the mean position, that is y is equal to 0, velocity is maximum and the acceleration is 0. So similarly, if we represent the movement of any particle, we know one complete wave can be represented by one circular motion. So if we say that when the particle is at mean position, y is equal to 0, the velocity it will be maximum in the either side, and the acceleration is oppositely direct, means antiphase. So if at the origin the acceleration is minus a omega square. So this is the way how we represent the phasor diagram of simple harmonic motion. Let us understand about the mechanical simple harmonic oscillator. One thing I would like to explain here, as per VTU syllabus, we are studying about the mechanical system, means a body we are considering, and we are trying to arrive for the equation, a body executing simple harmonic motion. But it is not that only the mechanical system have vibration or can be understood by vibration or oscillation. We have electrical system as well, where the oscillation or the vibration occurs. And for the example, if we take LCR circuit, we explain that with the oscillation of the system or the vibration of the system with respect to some frequency.